Hello everyone. I would like to welcome you all in my class of CIS 2168 Data Driven Design. This is part 3A of temporal analysis, and in this session we'll focus on statistical plots. I am Dr. Harimohan Pandey from the Department of Computer Science, and my email ID is given here. We'll start this session by taking a quick recap on what we did in part number 1 and 2 of temporal analysis. So here you can see in part number one, we covered basics of temporal analysis. Then we discussed three key questions, and which were related to first time, second day, and third data. And we used these terms to perform temporal analysis. We discussed how to extract day, time, and data from the given log file to perform temporal analysis. Then in part 2, the focus was on data frame. Then we used Python programming to implement data frames. In this session, the agenda is to explore multiple statistical plots. So all in all, we are going to discuss three most popular statistical plots. Number one is bar plot. Second, we will discuss box plot. And the third plot, which we will discuss, is referred as violin plot because of its structure like a violin. So we are going to discuss these three plots for data visualization and to see the distribution of data. To see the distribution of the data, we'll use these plots. This is part 3A. Of temporal analysis, and in this part we'll focus only on bar plot. Then in 3B we'll see box plot, and 3C we'll dedicate for violin plot. In the next slide, I have given a bar plot to explain the basics of bar plot. So this slide represents a bar plot, and it is one of the most popular graph to visualize the data, and it provides basic overview over the data. It represents categories in the data. So here you can see four rectangular bar are shown in this bar plot. Let me call it C1 category 1, C2 category 2, C3 category 3, and C4 category 4. So what bar plot does, it represents categorical data to show the distribution of the data of an individual category. So it is representing for C1, C2, C3, and C4. Another important thing for bar plot is the length or the height of the bar or rectangle. If the length or height of the rectangle is higher, it means that that particular category has more value as compared to any other category. In this example, you can see that the length or the height for category C4 is more than C3, C2 or C1. It clearly indicates that the value of category C4, its value is higher than C1, C2 and C3. Similarly, the value of C1 is higher as compared to C2 and C3 because the rectangle presented for C1, its length or height is higher than C2 category and C3 category. If we will compare between C2 and C3 category, then C3 has higher value as compared to C2 category. So what is the benefit of bar plot and how we can visualize? By looking the length or height of the rectangle, we can clearly see that which category has higher value and which category has lower value. And this is known as number of occurrence of the categories or statistical estimation. Another important thing for bar plot is we can plot vertical bar plot, we can plot horizontal bar plot, and vertical bar plot is sometimes referred as column bar plot. So these points are the basic points for a bar plot. In the next slide, I have given an example for horizontal as well as vertical bar plot. So two examples are shown here. This is example number one, and this one is example number two. Example one shows horizontal bar plot, whereas example two is for vertical bar plot. In example number one, x-axis represents COVID-19 patients, CP is COVID-19 patients, and y-axis represents the categories. It represents the categories, and categories are nothing but the country name. Similarly, in the second example here, x-axis represents country name and the country names are nothing but the categories in example number two. So all in all, we have 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 different categories, and y-axis in example two represents COVID-19 patients. So here you can see, as I mentioned in the previous slide, the length or the height of the rectangle represents the value of the category. So here New Zealand is one of the category. I'm calling it, let's say C1 is equal to New Zealand. And it has its length is higher as compared to any other categories or country. It means that number of COVID-19 patients in New Zealand is higher as compared to any other countries or any other categories. Whereas this country, that is C-END, category, last category, or C last, let me call it C last, last category, it has very small rectangle, small. So what does it mean? It means that this category has smallest number of COVID patient as compared to any other categories in example number one. In example number two, you can see there are two rectangles given. The first rectangle, that is this, represents the peak 7 days rolling average, whereas the second rectangle represents last week average. So in Spain, the peak value of the patient is higher, very high, in 7 days rolling average, and the last week average is lesser than 50. Similarly, for other countries or for other categories, we can visualize the data using the bar plot. So bar plot will give you very clear idea about the data distribution. And using these two examples, you can see that you can plot horizontal as well as vertical bar plot. You can see which category has higher value, which category has lower value. You can perform comparative study like this for individual category, and then you can see the distribution of the data using the bar plot. In the next slide, so this is all about bar plot. In the next lecture, we will see box plot.